I went into Letters of Iwo Jima not expecting to enjoy it because I don't normally like historical dramatic movies, but I really, really liked it. It starts out a little slow, and it's kind of hard to get into and get yourself to watch it just because it's long. It's really long, and it's all in subtitles because they're speaking in Japanese. So you have to be patient and be willing to read the subtitles because otherwise you can't watch the movie. Once you really get into it, though, it's actually really good. It shows you World War II from the Japanese perspective, which is a perspective that we don't normally get because they were fighting against us. And it kind of shows that in war, there is always two sides. And as much as we may hate the other side, they're still made up of real people with real families and real lives. You found yourself, or well, at least I found myself, sympathizing with the Japanese through the whole movie. And I mean, that's what you're supposed to be doing. Although it seems obvious that it's actual people fighting who have lives and homes and families, it's really easy for us to forget that just because it's not as simple as, say, the tsunami in Japan. Like, we can feel sympathy for them in that case because we weren't involved at all. We weren't the ones who, like, caused the tsunami. But in the case of war, we're the ones who are doing the killing. And so, in order to do that, we kind of have to forget that they're human on the other side. There's the scene, I think it's really brilliant with Sam, and they're reading the letter from his mom, and they all look kind of almost guilty at having caused his death because it's this letter from his mom hoping that he can come back safe and sound and like telling him to just do what is right because it is right. And they look guilty, and then outside, the Americans start to bomb them, and so they have to go right back and fight more Americans and kill more Americans. And so while they can remember this humanity for this split second, they have to go back and kill for their survival. All philosophical stuff aside, the music is great, the cinematography is great. I love the color. There's at one point where it looks almost black and white, and then somebody gets shot, and you see this bright spurt of red blood come out of him, and it's so dramatic and so impacting, and the way that they did that just made it so perfect for that moment. The acting is kind of hard to tell since they're not actually speaking English, so we can't hear them. I mean, we can hear them talking and but we're more paying attention to the subtitles, so it's harder to judge their acting skills. I know the American actors weren't all that good. I wasn't convinced by their acting. But you know, apart from that, it was like even with that, like it was really, really a good movie. And Saigo is a lucky, lucky guy. And I really just, the entire movie, I was like pleading that he would make it back to his wife and his daughter. And I'm pretty sure I cried at least three times, or I shed like one tear at least three times. It's sad, but it was really good. I definitely recommend this, even if you don't like historical dramas, even if you think it's gonna be too long, if you're not gonna wanna read this. Read the subtitles, sorry. It's definitely worth taking the time to watch and taking the effort because it's honestly a really, really good movie and it really does kind of make you think and make you remember that, hey, on that other side, there's still people, and as much as we do have to forget that sometimes, you really should hold on to it and remember it because it's the truth and it's important. So. Great movie. Good job, movie club. Oh, and the people who made the movie, obviously. Duh. Okay, bye.